Hey, everybody! Welcome to Stumped. This is Ash. I'm joined by Rick Price and Jasmine.
Hello!
We're playing Small World.
Small World!
Small World 2, to be precise.
Yep.
This is for Tabletop Day, which is... when this video goes up, it'll be a day late for that, but we're playing it on Tabletop Day.
Presently. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So, let's get into it.
Okay. I like this game a lot.
Love it. Love it.
Ash, prepare to play.
I haven't played two.
No, I think we've only played two. That's the one we played together.
We've only ever played the original.
Yeah.
Two is only on mobile platforms and
but okay. It plays roughly the same. Okay.
It was a Kickstarter, actually, I'm pretty sure.
Right.
Interesting. Okay.
Alright, so pick your race, Ash.
Right, so I actually really enjoy being... We actually have the expansion, right? Isn't there more than this?
Yeah, but you only get to choose. Remember, this is how it works.
Yeah, you
six
only get to choose.
Ones come out, and then you pick from those.
All right, so if anybody who's never played Small World before, Small World is a tabletop game.
Yes.
It's a really fun game. Basically,
Jazz, you can actually pull the thing out.
Peace Loving Elves is so perfect.
Anyways.
Yeah. I think I'm going to be Peace Loving Elves.
Anyways, the way you want to play this game is you want to pick a race and then conquer as many...
Right.
Tiles on the board, and every single time you grab a tile, you earn gold. And so by the end of the game, the person with the most gold wins.
Yeah,
it's not every time you grab a tile; it's at the end of your turn.
Yeah,
all the ones that you're in possession of.
Yeah, you earn
you gain one gold for.
Yeah, you earn one gold, but you have to start at the edge of the map. So Ash is conquering right now. He looks like he's got farmlands, a swamp, a meadow, and then he's also trying to get another farmland.
But he failed on that one, because if you don't have enough troops to just take it, you do a random roll.
So you have to have at least two tiles to take
You're guarding your spots, remember?
And if you want to conquer anybody that is already occupying a square, you need one extra piece for it. So like if there's only one guy on there, you just need one extra person.
So Ash just earned six gold, and why did you get double?
Oh, it's because he probably has a buff.
Some buff for it.
Here, Ash,
maybe it's
my turn?
Yep.
Yeah.
There you go.
Okay, so let's talk about what we're going to pick, because, Ash, you kind of jumped in to Peace Loving
Elves. For it. So the way that this works, randomly at the beginning of the game, it shuffles together what would you call this on the left?
There's a race and there's a trait.
Race and a trait, okay. And so those traits, they have different things. Rick, you go ahead and
Look at this new buff, Imperial. For each region in excess of three with your Imperial troops occupy at the end of the turn, collect one extra bonus coin. I am going to do that. But, you know, Alchemist sounds pretty cool, too.
But you see, the races and the traits, they randomly pair up. So you won't always get Alchemist humans.
Yeah.
Right.
Sometimes you'll get ransacking humans or berserking humans.
Berserk skeleton's actually pretty good.
It kind of is. So Berserk is you get to what is it?
You get to conquer for one less, right?
No, you actually get to gamble instead.
Yeah,
that's right.
Mm-hmm. The other thing to look at is if you pick something further down the list, it costs you coins. So
exactly.
Those coins on the side there, it's going to cost Jasmine four coins, say, if she wants to pick the commando trolls.
Exactly. Yeah.
So you have to factor that in.
And that doesn't necessarily mean that the ones at the bottom are better. It's just random.
Exactly.
So let's talk a little bit more about the actual races, the one we're going to pick. So trolls are really cool. So you don't get as many trolls, but what you can do is once you conquer something, you can actually put down a troll lair.
Yeah.
Trolls are annoying
as
hell.
They're
really
great.
And then, since I have commandos, it takes me one less troll to conquer an area. So
which means, Jasmine, that's a good combo, commando trolls. I was looking at that. I was like, I want that.
And how do you know how many trolls you have at the start of a turn? The numbers on the tiles.
Yeah,
that five and four mean that you have nine trolls to start with.
Yeah.
Whereas elves, for example, when they are from my next turns going forward, I get to have additional four elves, I believe. And then at the end of my turn, I take away those four.
It's pretty good, though, because you get to conquer more territory.
Exactly.
This game is all about conquering as much territory as you can. But the thing is, eventually your race is going to be stretched thin, and you'll need to put that race into decline
and pick
a new race. So it's all about knowing when to put your race into decline and pick a new race.
Oh, and then ultimately the way that you win is by having the most coins at the end of the game.
Exactly.
So that's the other part, is like trying to think, how can I get the most coins built
so,
up?
Conquer land, gather coins.
I believe the mountains, it sort of depends on the race and your factors and stuff, but certain lands will give you more money.
All right, Price, your turn.
Prepare to play.
Yeah.
I know that dwarves, for example, get way more gold from mountains, I believe.
Yeah.
No, they actually get gold from mines.
Mines.
There's a little tiny shovel icon that's a mine. And so if the dwarf is in there, he'll constantly be earning more gold.
But you can only get mines in mountains, correct?
I might take this.
Oh, no, it just randomly is random.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Underworld's cool because you can teleport, right?
Yeah. I'm going to take these guys. I'm going to try it out.
Okay.
Yeah. Let's see. I got 11.
You got 11. That's a lot.
It's a lot.
So you do well around
mountains.
So
I do well around mountains. So yeah. I'm going to take this one.
Sure.
I'm going to take this one because it's got a...
an underworld.
An underworld, which means I can conquer it for one less.
Yep.
That also means that any regions that are adjacent to underworlds, I can also just jump straight to, essentially.
And since you're also a...
take that one.
A giant. Any land around a mountain is one less for you, too.
Yes. So. And mountains are harder to conquer.
They certainly are.
So, let's see, how much of this will cost me? 3. This one cost me 2. So...
so you could, like, conquer some of the areas around it for one less.
Yeah. I think I'll go there. This will cost me 1. And here. Which, I've now spread myself very thin, which is kind of dangerous. But at the same time, since I have these mountain-type places...
because mountains are extra defense.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
It's harder to take.
Let's do like this.
Yeah, that's smart.
That, and I think I'll drop...
So what Price is doing is he's putting extra defense in these territories. Since he has 2 giants on that territory, it's going to be harder to capture now.
Yeah, so yeah. It'll require someone to do a little bit more, so to waste a little bit more of their resources to take it. I think I'm cool with that.
Yeah.
He's got 6 gold on that turn. Not bad.
Not bad.
Same as what Ash got. I think that.
Same as what
elves get.
Jazz got as well.
Yep,
I think.
I got 6.
Everybody got 6, so I had to at least get 6.
So that's another thing that's really clever about this game is you don't act. There's not any number thing that is running that shows you how much gold you have, and that's by design because the game is essentially if you're not like paying attention the whole time to exactly how much money everyone's getting and like keeping it track in your mind, then. You're not going to know if you're ahead or if you're not. So there is sort of a benefit to really paying attention to how much each person makes.
Yeah.
If you want to game it that way.
Huh. These races aren't the best.
I mean, there's a few of them that are kind of
I think Berserk Skeletons can be good.
Well remember, yeah, I mean, the top ones aren't too good
I was gonna say,
so far.
I mean, ghouls aren't too bad because remember, ghouls, once you go into decline, you can still use them.
What's the alchemist is pretty good. Collect 2 bonus victory coins at the end of each turn. Your race hasn't yet gone into decline. That's pretty
it's
good.
Not bad.
And each farmland region your humans occupy is worth 1 bonus victory coin at the end of your turn. That's not too shabby.
What's a kobold? I've never seen that one before.
A kobold. Oh.
Yeah,
oh, those
so
are the ratmen, aren't they?
You may never occupy a region with less than 2 kobold tokens. Oh, so you have to have at least 2 to conquer a land.
But you get 11 kobolds.
So you get way more.
Lots. Yeah, that's a
and
lot.
And then you also get +1 for each helium.
But I also have to spend 5 coins to get that, which
that's
I ain't
true.
Down for that. I think I'm going to take the humans.
And okay, so if you look at the top 2 now, the ghouls and the wizards, they have 2 coins sitting on them.
Which means that if you play them, you get them.
You get those. And so that's the other thing is like if a bad combo were to pop up and people kept skipping it,
and
eventually it will have a huge stack of coins on it, so it might actually be beneficial to take it just to get that huge influx.
We haven't really talked about that either, is that
once you go
we're not stuck with these races that we just chose.
Yeah.
Once we spread ourselves out and we're getting like the maximum amount of money that we think this race can ever get us, we want to put ourselves into decline, which means we give up the race, we give up the trait, and we're still sort of spread out, and those guys are still earning us money, but we can't ever move them again,
sure,
we can't ever do anything with them again. And we choose a new race, and we start over.
Whoops.
Grab it from there.
There we go.
Yeah, so the decline is a huge part of the way that this game works.
And I need to roll for that one. Let's try it.
Roll fizzle beef.
Ah!
You did it!
You did it, yeah.
Oh, cool.
Because when you click on it, it says what kind of a roll.
That's
you
right. Do. I had to roll more than 1.
So you can
that's easy. And then I'm going to redeploy this guy down here because I'm going to need to beef up that defense. And that's looking pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to go ahead and end my turn.
And you got an extra 1.
I did pretty good that.
7.
Yes.
Because of your alchemy stuff.
Yep.
Yeah.
All right.
So Ash, what does it say that the peace-loving and the elves get?
So elves, if they...
collect 3 bonus victory coins at the end of each turn during which you attacked no active race. Oh, so that's why you got so much last time.
That's pretty good.
Was because since you didn't attack any active race, you only attacked the whole...
Here's the tough thing about peace-loving elves, though, is if you get trapped in, you have to expand,
sure.
And so you're going to lose that buff.
Yeah.
Grab him down there.
That's right. Okay, so I'm going to expand over there, and... Oh, okay. I didn't realize it was going to take all of that to do that.
So do the goblins count as an active race?
What goblins?
Or like if he were to move up to the north
They don't. And that's why he got it last time, because he did kill some of them last time, but they're not an active race. An active race is someone being played by a person.
Right.
Okay.
Yep.
That looks good.
Cool.
So I should get a decent amount of money
four,
for each
five,
one.
Six
plus
nine.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Pretty good.
All right,
Jess.
Because you had the six that you got before plus what you earned this turn. Pretty good. Pretty good.
All right. So I only got three of these guys. So let's take that one, Sarg. You didn't get it, so.
Well, I'm gonna get it.
Oh, are you?
You wait.
Oh, you gonna get it. And she took another farm.
Rick gonna give it to you.
What?
I can't redeploy anything.
No, you can't. You got nothing. So Jasmine's gonna need to go into decline on her next turn.
But I am
very spread. And those troll cave things,
they last.
Make them really difficult to conquer. Can you even conquer? Does it just make them stronger?
They just, it just adds a...
It adds one additional
defense.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Gotcha. Okay. Well then. So that would cost me a little bit more to take.
Yep.
Two. That one would take one. That one would take
four.
This would take three. I think I'm gonna just be a complete dick. So I'll take that.
Oh, you're gonna go for me.
What are you gonna do about it, you peace-loving elf?
Yeah, I'm gonna try and do something about this.
Oh, one?
And then I'm looking around to see if are there any more caves upon which
I may
conquer.
It just seems so weird that you'd be an underground giant.
I know, right?
Yeah, right?
Because giants going under
those
the ground.
Those ceilings are so low, it's forcing us out. And then this one would cost me... I'll try it. Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, nice.
Redeploy. I know that I'm making bad decisions as far as, strategy and whatnot, and I'm pissing people off, but... It makes it exciting! All right, Rick, here you go.
Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Woo!
Ten coins.
All right.
Ash.
Oh, yeah, it's Ash's turn.
Is it?
Wait, what happened to my turn?
Right?
You didn't go into decline, did you?
No.
My defeated troops, because you defeated some.
Right. So then, Jazz, you'll probably have to do the same thing.
So...
No, I actually...
Oh, no, because you lost it, because you only had one.
Ash gets his troops back, because elves are peace-loving.
Well, the other thing is, if you lose a fight...
Because I lost this, so I have to redeploy these troops that I lost.
And yeah, the elves do, though, they get more back or something like that. But the thing is...
No, they get them all back.
Right, yes. And then Jasmine... But normally what happens is if you have more than one on a space...
Conquer some regions.
You only lose one, redeploy the rest of them. Yep. But you only had one, so I killed
one. All right, let's see. So, it's been a while since I played, so I'm going to have to... Let's see, I can go here, right? That would cost four.
It's going to cost four, yeah.
That's quite a lot. Let's see, what about this mountainous region up there?
See, the humans are really good for farms, so it really, it's kind of like for that, the four that you put into that, you do get like twice as much, right? You get plus one per farm area.
Yeah.
So it might, it's kind of a wash. The other thing you can do, how much does that green spot cost you?
I thought that was part of this.
If you grab that, then you could random roll for that one. You only have to roll a one.
That's true.
You could try it. Nope.
Come on.
Redeploy.
You son of a bitch.
Redeploy, though. You got them on the side.
Let's see. There we go. Deploy one there.
It's interesting. One of the races that we can pick... It says cursed on it as
it's
one of the traits.
They get no bonus.
They get no bonus.
And no, they get, look, it's, you get no bonus. I think you get three coins, but you get no bonus
units. It's minus three coins.
It's minus three coins. Oh. And it's never going to have money on it, so no one's ever going to choose it.
It can have money on it.
No.
But what's good about leprechauns, so that's the thing.
That it gains from what?
From people skipping it.
No, because no one's ever going to skip it because it's at the bottom.
No, but once we start going through a couple of these.
It'll get shifted up.
That's true. That's true.
All right. Price, get the fuck out of here.
That's
all right. Get out of here.
Let's see here.
It was worth it just to piss you off.
Yeah. You ain't getting that plus four.
Not today.
All right.
You got no troops
to redeploy.
Yeah, I ain't got no race. You ain't got no money.
I'm not going to get the bonus this time because I wasn't peaceful.
Ha! You only got seven gold.
So I essentially took money from you.
It's nothing to sneeze at.
All right, I am going into decline. So once your race is spread out way too thin, you can actually decline it.
Yep.
And so what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to lose a turn to decline it this time. And
she'll still collect gold for what the tiles that her declined race are still on.
Yep.
And the forts still stay, right?
Yep, they sure
do. That's insane.
So those guys are going to be really heavily defended. Mm-hmm. for the whole time that she's her next race. And I'm going to do the same thing. So that means I'm not going to redeploy, because if I were to redeploy this guy,
yeah,
then I would lose my
chance to decline.
So yep. I'm just going to do that.
So you can only have one race in decline the entire game. So if I choose another character and put him in decline, all my trolls will just disappear.
That's right.
Except there are like traits and stuff that let you have multiple races in decline.
Yeah, right, exactly. Ones. But standard, you don't get to do that.
Yeah.
All right, let's see here. I've still got four. There's.
You could still take that one farm from
her. Yeah, I could. That would be a little bit easier, I think. Now.
Just as far as because that's the only farm you can get, really.
I know.
Just take one of Price's.
It makes him more if he takes yours.
Yeah, it's true. It does. I'm going to do that.
Yeah. And now you can redeploy those.
I'm going to redeploy these four.
Which you know that we're not attacking you from either of those sides. So.
The only thing I have to worry about is Ash, really. So I'm going to just go ahead and redeploy
this guy here.
Yeah. And you know what? Just for safe measure, I'm going to just put three up there.
There you go.
That peaceful son there. Of a bitch.
I'm peaceful, so I'm not really looking to
fight. I don't believe your peaceful lies.
Those sneaky elves.
That was a pretty good play.
That
10.
Yeah.
That was pretty good.
All right.
Tell me.
That made up for the 7 I had last time.
I've got 3.
Okay.
That's. I was hoping to take 2 more tiles this turn. I'm not sure that's doable.
You could take actually.
I could maybe take these 2.
And then roll for 1.
What about that one?
There is the one in
between.
There, yeah. That's easy.
What about that one?
Yeah, but this would cost 2, right?
Yeah, everything
and this would cost 2?
Everything would cost you 2.
Or would it cost 3 because there's a guy on it?
They cost extra if there's a guy on it.
Yeah, so this would cost 3, right?
I don't know. Check. Hover. Yeah.
Yeah, it would cost you 3.
Yeah,
3.
It would cost me all 3.
Yeah, yeah, so you can take one or the other.
Same.
Yeah.
It's all the same.
And the mountain would cost 3, right? Because it's a mountain. Yep.
Go in decline.
All right.
There it goes.
All right, and so Jasmine's going to get first pick new race.
Swamp sorcerers sound kind of cool.
Swamperers.
Swamp sorcerers. Okay. Yay, I get to choose a new race. All right, so ghouls, I can do imperial. For each region in excess of 3 of your imperial troops occupy the end of your turn, collect one bonus code.
So ghouls you can keep using after you go into decline.
Yeah, right? Which is pretty... But you can keep attacking with them. It's pretty great.
What does ransacking do?
Every time you successfully conquer a region containing an opponent's active race tokens. Oh, it's active. Everybody went in decline this time.
Yeah.
I didn't do it. Snarf.
Sorcerers can flip. A single token or something like that.
You could actually take over another person's token.
Yeah, if there's only one person's token over there, they can like take it, right?
Yeah.
But I think it has to be adjacent as well.
Let's do skeletons.
All right.
Yeah.
Skelebones.
Yeah, the berserk skeletons look good.
Okay. So let us start conquering. It's coming from up here. All
right. It rolls every single time.
To
give you a bonus, essentially.
Yeah. So I could use some less...
Less of your tokens, yeah.
It's pretty good.
They're really good.
Yeah.
And skeletons have a huge number advantage as well, so like that's the kind of the other thing. Like when they, is it when they die, or when they kill someone else, you gain more skeletons?
I think so.
Damn, look at how quickly you expanded. It's nuts.
No, they're great when you have a combo like Berserk or Commando or something like that.
Not enough.
Oh, but you can't, you can't do the...
Because the most you could get is 2.
Okay.
That
so
one
I think,
plus
I think the
one.
Thing is, you can't do the random roll that everybody else can normally do. Is the
so
thing.
So I'll just put you. I'll just redeploy. There you go. Redeploy. Yep. And here, and here. And let's put one on you. There we go.
So Jazz is going to get coins for all of her skeletons and all of her trolls.
All of her trolls. So she's going to get a ton this turn.
Yes, she is.
Look at me go. I got gold.
Jasmine is in pretty good position.
What are you gonna be, Bryce?
I don't know. Ghouls, your ghoul tokens all stay on the map. In addition, unlike other races.
Oh, what's the new one down there at the bottom? Goblins and Horde.
Hordes of goblins.
Please, 2 Horde tokens, exactly 0 additional active race tokens of your own.
They disappear and you go into decline. Okay, yeah.
Oh, so it's Hordes. Oh, they come in and they act like,
Oh, you conquer decline quicker.
Oh, that's actually
that's really
nice.
Good, actually.
For this turn, that's actually really good.
Yeah, but it's good for the next several turns because those decline things are going to be around for
that's
forever.
That's true.
But it would cost me a lot of gold. Collect one bonus victory coin for each hill.
11 kobolds. That's 15 kobolds. That's pretty good.
But it requires a lot of kobolds to conquer, right?
They have to have two in each spot to actually hold it.
Oh, right.
It's worth one bonus victory coin. Each time you successfully conquer a region containing an opponent's active race, you immediately receive a victory coin.
Right.
I like these guys, I think.
Ransacking Wizards.
And I got some coins for picking them up because they
sounds like a sports team.
Over quite a bit.
The Portland Ransacking Wizards.
All right, so that would cost me four. That would cost me four, four, four.
Do some serious whiz biz.
Three. And you're in decline. I think... but you're right there. Jasmine's right there.
Yep. It's going to cost you a lot.
Nine. Good.
This is tricksy, but I don't really want to let Jasmine like get out of control.
Yeah, that's a good call.
So we're going to do that.
Nice.
And I'll do that. And I'll try my hand at a random. It's all good.
Tap break.
And my redeploy is pretty simple.
You're one.
And yeah, I'll take that.
Two, three, sweet. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 11.
Oh, not bad.
Oh, 10.
Okay.
I miscounted.
Oh,
Jess. Jess has to redeploy.
I gotta put my skeleton somewhere.
Jeez.
Jess. I gotta put my skeleton.
And so, as you can see, something that I did that's often the case is when you go back into the game, when you bring your next race in, you do it near some of your other guys, the ones that are in decline, because you can protect them better. That way.
All right, I still got three, but I'm gonna have
you
to put my race
into
decline sooner, sooner or later.
You got five regions.
I think
plus
I got
two.
10 last time, which
you got six regions and two are farms, so that's plus two. So you have 8 gold worth, I think.
Yeah.
If I'm doing the math correctly. Oh, and then what's your alchemist do? Oh, but when you go into decline, alchemy goes away.
Yeah, yes. Exactly. Yeah. Oh shit.
You can take that mountain.
I could, but I mean, it's just a mountain, you know.
The question is, do you want to go into decline next turn or? Do you want to choose a new race next turn so you can actually conquer more? Or
yeah.
Do you want to gather one more token?
I know, and I really don't. So I'm going to go ahead and go into decline. There we go. Right.
Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
That wasn't too great, but hopefully the next round I will make up for it.
Oh, right. Do they not keep the farm ability?
No.
Oh, that sucks.
Yep.
All right.
Ooh,
what
barbarian
are the ones at the bottom?
Werewolves.
Were-barbarians.
Were-barbarians. Each
Were-barbarians,
I like.
Were-barbarians,
yeah.
Even-numbered game turns, you may conquer all regions with two less race tokens than normal.
Oh!
Oh, so it's every even turn.
Uh-huh.
Which is, I think, this turn.
How do we know? No, we're on turn 5.
Cannot redeploy their troops.
Okay, so the next one.
I like those barbarians.
Interesting. Mm-hmm. So they can't redeploy.
Interesting. Again, that's the thing about the ones that go to the bottom is it's like, you know.
Where barbarians? Ooh. During
like
redeployment, you may
ghouls.
Drag one
that's
pot of gold
say,
each region.
Yeah.
But never more than... Oh, I was reading that. Now you might as well be ghouls.
Nope.
I don't know what I want.
The werebarian sounds like a big angry bear to me.
Yeah, right?
Werebarian.
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 They can't redeploy, though. I don't know. I need...
Mel and I have been talking about
hypothetical
children's names.
Oh, yeah?
And Werebarian, I think, is high up on the list
now. That's a
good
one. That's a really good one. Oh, man.
Go for all of...
Yeah, and Rick, I'm going to
take
out your stuff.
Hey, buddy!
Oh, man!
Be a little diplomatic.
I won't forget this.
Take some of
wow.
Of
that was real dickish.
You're killing your own? You just killed your own?
Oh, I did.
Typical barbarians. Oh, no, you're goblins.
No, he's goblins.
Typical goblins.
Try it.
Oh, man.
No.
You lose.
All right.
You have one more, don't you? Oh, no, you're just on redeploy?
Okay.
Oh, because you did a random roll.
They act like races.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
There. Okay.
But they disappear in decline. That's
3, 4, 5,
killed
6,
your own
7,
space.
8, 9,
I can't see
10,
things, man.
10.
All right, Jazz.
Yay!
All right, Jazz.
Ransacking. The Zerk Skeletons. Conquer some regions. I'm doing it.
You can now either roll a die for your conquest or decline what you want to do. So you roll your die if you want to keep going.
Yeah,
that's a weird thing, but it, yeah.
Huh.
That was weird.
No, it's just because of her ability. She has to choose if she wants to roll the die or do the thing, I guess. Because maybe you don't have to. I don't know.
Do the thing.
Do the thing.
She's
do the
taking
bear, do
all
the thing.
Of the things.
Kill them goblins.
Let's go here. Oh,
bong.
Okay. Why not?
I don't know. Oh, well, whatever.
Is it because of the roll? I still don't understand that roll mechanic very well.
Oh, yeah, I should really beef up this area. Since price is coming in.
Pshh, what you talking about?
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, look at all the gold. 8, 9, 10.
Give me the cash.
11, 12, 13.
Wow.
13.
Yes. Jasmine's got a lot of money.
Yes.
Oh, 10
Where
minus.
Do you see our money totals?
We don't.
Remember, that's the whole thing.
Right.
Oh.
It's part of the fun. Part of the charm. So 3 to there. 3 to there. 5.
What's the winning total?
It's not a specific one. It's just whoever has the most.
At the end of the...
Yep. At the end.
How many rounds are there? 10?
Yeah, there's I think there's 10 rounds. Or it's based on the map, right? I guess we didn't choose the map that we wanted to play.
We have 9 rounds. You can see it's the 5 out of 9.
Oh, yep.
Right.
So I could do a 1 roll to maybe take one of Jasmine's spots there, or I could do this. And I think I'll do that. And we'll try.
No.
Oh, no.
There's no downside in trying.
No, that's true. There's no harm in trying. You wizards.
Serious whizbiz.
Whizbiz. Doing the whizbiz.
Ransack and wizards.
Who comes next, Rick?
It should be me. Ooh, nice one. Yeah. 12.
Oh. Not quite Jazz money, though. Jazz a little bit ahead.
All right.
All right, look at them ghouls.
Ooh, gypsies.
5.
Gypsies.
He gets 5.
What's gold. The bottom?
Wealth. Okay, so you start with, you get plus 7.
Like 7 bonus victory coins and once only.
Oh, the curse. To skip curse, it costs 3. That's what that means.
Oh, it costs 3 additional to skip cursed.
Yeah.
Which means it's going to eventually have a ton of money on it.
Exactly. Interesting.
Mm. You know what?
Go for ghouls.
I'm going for ghouls.
Yeah, you get 5 gold for taking them.
And ghouls aren't nothing to. Yeah, I'm Imperial, right? So in excess of which Imperial troops occupy at the end of your turn. Okay, so if I have.
3 on a single spot. Yeah. You gain
in excess of 3, so I have to have at least 4.
Okay.
That's a lot.
Yeah, so you don't want to spread your
spells. No, it also said, though, if you occupy more than a certain number of regions, you gain gold as well. So if you occupy 4 regions, you get plus 1, 5, plus 2.
Okay.
Oh,
yep.
So it's not about a bunch in a single spot. It's about having a large spot.
Right.
So you get
I
4,
see.
You get 1, 5, you get 2, etc.
Good. That's makes it a little bit better. All right, I got 9 ghouls. Let's see. 9
That's a lot of
ghouls. Yep. It's a lot of ghouls.
How much does it
ghouls.
Cost to kill the guy who killed you?
Seriously, right?
Still gonna.
Thing seems is, like all the edge regions.
It's so
are pretty...
empty over here, though, and I like that. That's.
But those all have the bunkers
they
on
do
it
all the
from
bunkers,
from
yeah.
Jasmine's.
The other thing I'm wondering is the
that
mountain
one
over there.
This one doesn't.
That
that's
one
right.
Doesn't. You should get that
oh
one.
Yeah, the mountain on the far left
is unoccupied. So that's also a cheap one to come
but
in
you're
on.
Still
yeah, but it's surrounded by goblins. If I come in over here, there's nobody
right.
to challenge
so
me.
So you can take those two, right? Mm-hmm. But then you're surrounded by Jasmine's trolls. So then all of those spaces take a while.
Well, I'm there, and then I can go there.
Mountains cost plus 1.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I know, man.
Never tell me the math.
Look,
that's
look.
Right.
We're also playing a game in which I want to defend my stuff. Jasmine wants to defend her stuff. That's why she's saying, yeah, go there. Take one of Price's regions. We're all going to say what benefits us the most.
Yeah.
That's how tabletop games work.
See, here's the thing, though. If I move on to the mountains, right, then I have to contend with these goblins, which cost 4, right? If I move here, I have to contend with these forts, which cost 4. So
why do the goblins cost 4? Oh, because he has 2 on each region?
Because
exactly.
I have 2 on each one.
Exactly. I can move in here.
That costs 3, yeah.
And it costs 4. So, I mean, it's pretty
it's 4
equal.
Everywhere, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's pretty similar.
Which means I'm going to move in here.
Okay.
And then I'm going to move here. And then I can roll.
Sure.
For one of these regions.
Hizzle beef.
I think I want to roll for this one. Come on. I just need more than 1. Come on. God damn it.
This random dice
Rick
is
rolls.
Bullshit.
But you know, since you have the Imperial one, I think you actually gained some money.
No.
Oh, not yet?
No, it's for having multiple regions.
Oh, gotcha.
Okay. Well,
at least you have large numbers. Ghouls do have large numbers, so that's
and
nice.
And then what's really great about ghouls is when they go in decline, they could still conquer.
I only got 5. That was so shit.
Yeah, that's all right.
Oh, it's me? Okay.
I hand it like this.
Oh, thank you.
It's like a platter.
Just think about it, Rick. When one of us goes into decline, that area is yours.
That's true.
Conquer
some okay.
He's going to conquer
Dear
my...
Jasmine.
Well, let's see. What's in decline over here? That's in decline.
Was that yours?
That was yours again!
Don't talk to me. All right.
Oh, man.
You dingus.
You can't you dingus. You're done.
That's the second time, buddy. Come on.
Hey, it's how he rolls, man. Let Ash play the game.
Yeah,
that
don't
Ash
talk
to
me about games.
Sorry. Sorry. I don't mean to backseat game, but
it's very reminiscent of me accidentally buying stuff in Crawl.
Oh no.
Yes.
Oh yes.
He just kept hammering that
I'm
bee.
Just so excited.
Just kept hammering that bee.
Oh man.
I'm still really confused about the rolling thing, the rolling mechanic. Redeploy.
I think that when you roll, you only get one additional skeleton.
Maybe
if you're going onto a tile that has four with two, then you can't take it because you would need two additional.
Right. I really need to beef up this area over here because Price, you were just like coming in.
I know what you're talking about.
Yeah. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15.
Someone is confident, but she's got reason to be.
Yeah.
You're going to have to go into decline sooner or later.
Oh, I know. Not yet.
Not yet, though.
Since I can
the Dragon Master's on the board.
At least gamble it.
Oh, Dragon Master's pretty good, but it's late game for that Dragon Master.
Well, I mean, you could take anything with the dragon. You can come in and just grab one thing.
And that's 11.
Fortified.
That's 13 Ratmen. That's pretty good.
Yeah, and you couldn't use that one dragon to take on anything that's heavily fortified for that dragon.
It'll cost you...
Just the dragon.
No, but I'm saying to get past cursed and stuff, it's going to cost, what, 8 gold to buy that Dragon Master?
Yeah.
How's it going, Press?
Just making decisions.
I don't think you can roll on any of those.
I can roll on plenty.
It's the only one you can roll on.
I can roll on several of yours. Quit saying, oh, it's the only one you can roll on.
Oh, you were like going up and down. I can't tell.
Yeah, I'm looking around. Jasmine's very, very clever at being like, oh, man, Price, there's so many options over on the other side of the world where I'm not.
Yeah, you can even roll on those troll ones.
Oh, yeah. I will roll on this
troll.
One, though. Ah! Shouldn't have done it.
Oh, no.
There was only a 1 in 6 chance you were going to get that, though.
I know. Those I can like... do maths.
Can you?
I can.
2, 3.
But
four,
I figured it was
six.
More. Oh, wait, it's Rick.
I think it's Rick.
It was more worth the risk, I think, because it's a magic
round.
Spot, so yeah. I get a double
Good
for
round,
that.
Though. Good round, though.
Oh, Jazz.
I have to redeploy.
That's right.
Right.
Come here, little skeleton.
So, yeah, part of the reason that Jasmine's been able to continue to be so powerful is because she gains skeletons every time she kills somebody.
Yeah.
So she's had such a huge number.
Yeah.
All right, ghoulies. Groovy ghoulies. Let's see. 4, 4, 4, 4, 4. Everything's 4, so.
Yeah.
So kill one of Jasmine's instead of mine.
Yeah. Well, I do want to go. I think I want to go down instead of up, so. See.
If you go that way, then you can finally start attacking Ash's stuff and some ground stuff.
Yeah.
That's just like less.
I'm going to go that way, and then I'm going to roll for one of these. No, I don't want to roll. I think I want to go this way. Come on.
Yes.
Yeah.
Kill Jasmine
and
stuff.
And redeploy. Please. Let's see.
Please.
Blocks.
I've got 4 now, so that's a bonus.
There you go.
And let's see, I want to read... I think that's fine.
Good.
Yep,
yeah.
Fine right where I am.
Can't come in immediately, so...
Still only 8. God damn.
What turn is it? It's turn 6.
Doing
so it's
shit.
About to turn 7.
I think I'm definitely not going to win unless I pull out some kind of miracle at the end.
I'm going to decline.
I'll go for it. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And then he loses all of his elves, but they're already gone anyways.
Yeah, because you took...
Half because of his own choices.
That, literally half.
Bam.
It was funny.
See, I meant to do it. I just took over the other area with my own new race. So.
All right, let's see.
Your race does not discriminate. You're like, I don't care what pact we had in the past. The past is the past.
Do-do. No, you have to redeploy. You can't take over new stuff.
Yeah. Oh,
I'm so confused by that, how that works.
I didn't see that.
That mechanic.
I think you should decline because it's just really confusing.
Exactly.
It is quite confusing.
Although she is making all the money in the world.
Yeah. That's true. Jasmine's going to
so
win.
So much money.
I don't know what to say, guys. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You better be.
No, I'm actually not now.
14.
Not now anymore.
So much.
Jasmine's going to win. There's no fucking question.
Okay, here's a decision I have to make.
What, decline or play?
I could go decline. How many monies do you, how many guys do I have? I have 4. How much would it cost to kill one of these? 4. Not really worth it.
For one additional coin?
For one additional coin.
Goodbye.
So I'm going to the decline.
Hey, yeah.
Whiz Biz is over.
And all
is over.
Those
now all the regions
gone.
That I was in are open.
With ghouls, can't I go into decline and still take
you can.
Territory?
Yes.
Yeah, I
but
can do that.
You'll, I mean, yeah.
But then I'll lose my plus 4.
You lose all of your...
All the giants are gone now, so you can start taking all the giant
that's
areas.
True. That's true.
Not,
yeah.
You know, it's not a huge loss.
Yeah. Let's see. Yeah, giants are gone. That's true. I've got 5 ghoulies.
You can go ahead and decline now, and so in that... Well, you can do it actually in the next turn. So in the last turn, you could just go crazy.
Yeah, that's true.
Which I think that's what I'm going to do. Take over that little empty space.
Oh, yeah. Empty. Boom. Then we can go... That's only going to cost 3.
It's free. Yep.
Yeah.
Everything's 3.
Well, they're 3 plus a roll.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Might as well take the one that's free.
Of Kears. And I don't really need to redeploy much. Well, around the edges, since you guys are going to come back in.
Exactly. That's what you got to worry about.
There we go.
Cool.
More monies for Rick.
All the monies.
Money. Look at all that money. Oh, that was a good round.
Finally.
Nice.
Finally,
Wowzers.
Get good numbers.
All right.
Oh, that was a lot. 12.
Ash, what are you going to do?
What do you have that gives you so much?
Because I got the bonus for having 5 characters.
Oh, the Imperial!
Mm-hmm.
Right! Super cool.
How many swamps are out there? Show the map.
It's quite
There's
a few
3?
Swamps.
4?
One on the troll, one on the edge that he's got, the one up there that I've got, the one over there that you've already got. There's like 5 or 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Hmm.
I kind of want to try barbarians.
What do the leprechauns do?
Barbarians.
Oh, what did the leprechauns do?
If an opponent... Okay, during redeployment, you may drag a pot of gold in each region your leprechauns occupy. Each pot of gold still present at the start of your next turn goes in your... Oh, so you... It's essentially a gold stash that you put there that if it doesn't get conquered...
You get more money.
You get more money. But if someone else takes it, then
but
they take it
you
away.
Only get 6.
Right. Oh, right, because you're cursed. Right. Right.
You can get wealthy and just grab like some extra coins.
That's plus 7. Well, it's going to cost him 6.
One victory coin is placed in each region that is abandoned at the beginning of the turn.
So the gypsies, you're constantly moving through, killing stuff, and then leaving them?
And then leaving them.
So the wealthy essentially cancels out the negative effect of having to pass the curse. But
and
still...
I think this is an even turn. Is it? Show map.
Yes,
it's an even turn, so all your barbarians would be werebarians.
Oh, yeah, the werebarians.
Yeah. That's a good start. Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to do it.
Nice.
Werewolf.
Kill Jasmine.
I like that. That was so
That's
cool.
Awesome.
And you've got 13 of them, too.
You
got
to come in on the side, remember?
I know. I'm just looking around.
That costs 1. 1, 1, 1.
Jesus.
1. Wow.
That's actually, this is the best round ever.
This is amazing. Kill more of Jasmine's. I mean, take as much of mine as you want, but kill more of Jasmine's because she's way ahead of the rest of us.
You should take a little one.
Is that going to cost 1 as well?
See how there's price right in the middle of the mountain?
Yeah, that counts 1. That's 1.
Yeah, that's 1 as well. That's 2. That's 1.
Oh my god, Ash. This is the greatest
that's
thing
ever.
That's
1.
How many do you have left? Hold on. You have 6?
I have 6
two,
left.
2, 1, 1. You can take those 4 regions in that horseshoe because those each only have 1 person on a solo.
Mm-hmm. Good lord.
Yeah.
Wow, Ash,
fucking
that was
brilliant.
Crazy.
I'm okay with as much damage as you did to me because you did a ton of damage to Jasmine, so I'm okay with
which
that.
Which should hopefully 10, decrease how much
money. Look at this! Ash, 16, Ash just annihilated.
17.
Nice. Look at that turn.
Killed it.
Well done, sir.
Werebarians.
Werebarians. Jasmine, you going to go into decline?
Yeah, I'm going to decline this. This is the last turn to go into decline.
That's perfect
because
now your region is empty.
Last turn to go into decline.
Yep.
Think about it.
That's true.
Only 3 gold for Jasmine.
So Jasmine just like that was a big.
But every turn I had was like 15 gold.
No,
pillaging orcs.
Oh.
That is one of the best that exists.
Yeah, pillaging is super good.
Oh, I was going to do Dragon Master Ratman.
Because that means it's a negative two. You could get a lot of stuff for free, basically, right?
Which one?
The Pillaging Orcs. I mean, that's a negative one, and it's a negative one for Orcs,
right? Each
non-empty
region you conquer.
But it's going to cost you.
Bonus. Each non-empty region is bonus. So essentially, anytime I attack
bonus.
Guys,
got it. That's
you get
right.
bonus.
Sorry,
it's going to cost you seven to get.
But the Ratman, I can take more stuff. I just get a lot of numbers, and then I get the Dragon Master, which is pretty good.
What am I thinking of?
I might take that.
There's a trait that lets you take over an area
commando?
For one less. That's right, commando. And there's also a race that can take over stuff for one less as well, right?
Oh, that's
so like having
stack.
Both of them is like insane.
Jeez, look at all this.
But yeah, Pillaging Orcs is one of the best as well.
Yeah.
You went for rats?
I went for rats.
Why are you going to go after my ghouls?
Because it's cheaper.
King of the rats.
King of the rats.
3-3-3-3. I could kill some Ash's stuff, or I could go after more of Jasmine's stuff. Which I kind of would rather, because Jasmine was so cocky about it earlier, I kind of, and look, hold on. Really quickly, look at the upper left of the rat's image. It's a little block of cheese.
Yeah.
Oh, it is a little block of cheese.
It's a piece of cheese, I can't help it. All right, so I'm killing Jasmine.
Get rid of the rest of my skeletons.
Get rid of that. And which one
just
these,
remember, you also have your dragon.
I know. So I got to find which one's the cheapest. They're all, it looks like twos and threes. So we'll go for...
Yeah.
Dang. And then.
And you can just use your dragon to.
All right. I know I'm redeploying. Do I not get? Do I pick it after I redeploy?
I think you're supposed to use your dragon first. I think you botched the dragon.
Did I?
Yeah, because the dragon has to be used with a dude.
Oh, that's bullshit. Jasmine, you knew that, didn't you?
I was wondering what you're doing, but no, I wasn't going to say anything. I wasn't going to say
Why
anything.
Why would she? That's crazy.
Son of a bitch. That sucks.
Well, if you. I think you can put down your dragon somewhere, can't you?
No, I can't. No. You have to use it with the thing.
Yeah, it's great.
Thanks for telling me, guys! The ones of you who knew. I'm angry at everyone right now, but whatever. I got revenge on Jasmine a little bit, so I'm fine with that.
All right, let's see. All right, if I want to go in decline, this is the turn to
do
it.
This is the turn to do it, and you can still conquer.
Which you want to do as ghouls, because you still get to use them after you go into decline.
Yeah. I'm going to lose my plus four, though. Or no, my plus two. It's
right,
only plus two.
Right, yeah, plus two, yeah.
That's not that bad.
To go into decline, and you should still be able to.
You'll be able to next turn.
Oh, okay.
You'll get one more push in, and that's about it.
But all your ghouls stay on the board.
Yeah.
And.
Ash.
And me.
All right, werebarians.
Daytime, you are not a werebaran anymore.
You're less wearable.
I can only take over one more tile.
Now you're just a barbarian.
Yeah,
a barbarian.
You're done, but you got so much money that last turn.
Yeah, you.
And you're gonna get a ton this turn too. I think this just might have pushed Ash into the lead.
Maybe
the money, like that's the thing. The money is so close right now. I think that I have no idea.
It's not close for me. I can guarantee you.
Man,
that's essentially like two turns that you just had.
And it's great that it's happening while Jasmine's not making any money. So
exactly.
I have no idea where the money's at right now.
Where's the money, Lebowski?
Oh, Jazz, you could get 9 coins for taking the cursed thing.
Could.
Holy shit.
I'm just putting it out there.
He could. Damn you.
No one's going to, like, grab me, too. So.
You knucklehead.
He could have, which would have put Jasmine at a disadvantage because she would have gotten less on the next turn, which would have been better for both of us.
What next turn?
Oh, you're done. Yeah.
Yeah.
See?
But for her turn, she wouldn't have gotten as much.
Yeah.
Long game, Ash.
What?
I am
over.
Angry at Ash right
Game's
now.
Over for me.
You could still have won!
If I lose my 9 points,
I don't think you're
going to
get those because there's not a next turn, so...
Yeah, you're not going to get the pot of gold.
Yeah.
But I think, Rick, you could probably gain something by taking those, can't you?
Yeah, I should be able to.
I think. Nice. I'm not sure. Conquer some regions. Okay.
Yeah,
First and foremost...
Where are you?
I'm up here. I will conquer... Which one's the most difficult to take? That one, probably.
Probably that one.
Damos.
The most.
Actually, these ones might be easier to take, though. And Jasmine's not anywhere near me anyway.
Do you have to use it right first?
Couldn't
you take territories and then use it?
I could have taken some and then used it, but the thing is I was worried that I would forget.
Yeah.
So that's how that works.
This is what could happen, is he could have gone south and then used the dragon on my little leprechaun and taken the pot of gold too.
I think the pot of gold
doesn't give you anything. It just prevents you from getting a bonus from it.
Which you're not going to get anyway.
You're not
right, because there's not a next turn.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, well.
All right, yep. 9.
Ash, you really fucking pulled it out of
those
the hat.
Last couple. All right,
let's
moves.
See. What do I want to be? I might as well just be the kobolds because there's fucking 15 of them.
Let's think. Let's
or
think.
You could also go for gypsies and just get an extra 7 gold.
You do get the 7 gold. You lose 2 for picking, but you get plus 7. So
and
that
then you
might
also get
actually be more valuable.
One extra coin for every but I get region you abandon.
I get 4 here, and then I've got 15.
That's true.
Kobolds.
But you could also abandon all of the regions that you take over.
It is really kind of a wash between the two, but I don't know how you can abandon regions.
That's
easily.
What I was going to say,
when you
yeah.
redeploy, you just take them out.
No, you can't yeah, redeploy no. out of territory.
It's like
you
it would take 2 turns.
Exactly.
Okay.
So,
okay. Prepare thy ghouls.
So, yeah, I think this is the smarter place since
you
get
there.
More
you have
of them.
Over there. So you have 3 ghouls over there.
You see you got 3 extra ghouls on the
on
side.
The left.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
So just start grabbing areas.
Take that zone.
Yep, there's this one, and then there's this one. Fucker.
It's all good. Redeploy your
ghoul first.
Your ghoul boys, he's on the side.
It really doesn't matter.
You have to put the one over. Some ways.
There you go.
Okay, and then next. Prepare the hill ghoul kobolds.
You want hills.
I want the hills.
What are the hills? Are the hills the ones
it's
with the sheep?
The green with the sheep.
So you can kill Jasmine's leprechauns,
or you can
kill some of my rat men.
Is this not a hill?
That might be a hill.
That's a forest, I think.
No,
I think
that's definitely not
a hill. That's a hill. But then you'll have to contend with your ghouls.
Unless you go down across the mountains.
Or you can go up to the rats.
Yeah,
there's
or you
a
can
bunch of
hills. Right
yeah.
here.
Yeah.
There's
yeah, those are all hills right there through all of that.
Could go here and then take these 2 hills.
Yep.
Yeah, that's probably the smart move. That costs 5, that costs 3.
Remember, you have to leave some kobolds behind.
That's a hill right there that has my rats. The only reason I'm telling you is
I know, it costs 5, though. I'm just
but it gives you 2 gold instead of 1, so just think how many more moves you have left.
I got 4 here. That costs 3. That costs 4.
One.
That costs 4.
You should probably do one that costs 3, and then you can roll for another.
Yeah.
Yeah. So maybe go for that swamp and then for the last hill.
Where's the last hill? Up to the top?
No, you can't reach that. He can't reach that?
He'd have to kill my rats in the middle.
He'd have to kill your rat, and then he could roll for the last one, right?
But how much does it cost to take the rat?
I think it only costs 3.
On the swamp, you mean?
On the swamp with the rat.
Okay, see, when you were pointing up at the rat over here, so...
I know what I'm pointing at.
No, but I mean, but what I'm saying is he was hovering over it, and you're like, yeah, go for the rat.
Okay, I'm just going to do this. Okay. And then I'm going to... Oh, I can't roll.
Good
boy.
See, I couldn't even roll anyway.
Oh, because they had to have 2 in a region.
Yes, they're kobolds.
Oh, so you just have to redeploy now, buddy.
God damn it, I should have taken the fucking hill.
Sorry, buddy.
That's what I pointed at.
I know.
He wouldn't have been able to, though, because he has to kill 2 to get there.
Because he wouldn't have had
the
enough.
Distance.
Yeah.
This is it, guys.
All right.
This is it.
I hope Ash wins. Just because Jasmine was so sure of herself.
Yeah, 13.
That's a lot of money.
That's not that good.
There it is.
Let's see. Who's got the pile?
Oh my gosh, look at all that coins.
All the coins.
Rare!
Done, sir. We're all super close, though.
I know. Rick, how did you win?
I have no idea. I was sure that I would be the last one.
I was off by 1.
You were off by 1.
Yes! Yes! Yes!
Well done, good sir.
I am so happy right now.
I have no idea how that happened.
Rick, that's the underdog. That's
the amazing part about this game is you really have no idea what's happening until the
very It had to have been just the purchasing of races and stuff that you guys were doing.
Yeah. All right, everybody.
Ash, you came up really quickly.
I know. If you had not taken what I told you, the 6 gold worth cursed one, then you probably, I'd be ahead of you.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Oh, you were 1 away, Jazz.
I blame Ash for everything.
All right, everybody. We've got some more board games. When this video comes up on Sunday, I believe the Humble Bundle will still be up. So go check it out. It's got this game. It's got like 6 other board games on it.
Ticket to Ride.
Yeah. 100% Orange Juice. Anyway, we got more board games to play for the channel is what I'm trying to say. So you'll probably see some more of these. So let us know if you're liking these.
Good
if you want to see us play more board games for the channel. Anyway, we've been stumped. I've been Astro, Maverick, Price, and Jasmine. If you like what you saw, give us a like, give us a favor. Be sure to subscribe. We'll catch you all next time.
Bye! Bye.